You should. We'd all treat each other a lot better if that was the case. It's just hard. The brain doesn't pick up on little subtleties like that very well. That negativity bias is just a small piece of a bigger problem, which is that our brain just focuses on extremes. This is part of learning. You learn something, and your brain doesn't want to have to relearn everything all the time, so it becomes habit. You don't think about it. You're kind of going through the motion. You came into this world, bright-eyed baby. Everything was interesting. You learned to crawl, got it, walk, got it, jump, recalibrate. You know. And everything just becomes going through the motions, and you kind of lose sight of an appreciation for 99.9% of reality, and you focus on those extremes. And I'll give you a great example of this. Like when I broke my feet, I went around to a bunch of different doctors, different parts of the country even, and they all said the same thing. They all acted like this is common sense, like everyone knows this. They all go, "So how high up were you when you jumped?" I was like, "I don't know, I jumped off higher, angle was weird, I was wearing bad shoes, probably 10, 12 feet, something like that." Every one of them was like, "Ooh, yeah, 8 feet. That's the threshold. That's when stuff starts breaking. 8 feet. Oh, 8 feet is the threshold? How come I didn't know 8 feet was the threshold? How come we all don't know 8 feet is the falling, jumping, broken bone threshold?" That seems like easy information to impart on the youth. They taught us stop, drop, and roll, and I've never seen anyone on fire before. People are jumping off crap all the time. Stop, drop, and roll. If you're on fire, you're probably in a fire. I'm not sure rolling around those coals is the best thing for you. Seems like more of a case-by-case kind of prescription. 8 feet, though, that's a good standard. Could have used that. We've all been eyeballing jumps our whole lives. Instead, you could just go, "Oh, 8 feet, can't do it." Boom. Who knows what to do if a shark attacks you? Shout it out if you know what to do if a shark attacks you. Yeah, punch you in the nose, poke it in the eye. You're all perfectly prepared for a shark attack. In Madison, Wisconsin. Eight feet. Who knows what to do if a bear attacks you? Play dead? No, punch it in the dick. Yep. You ever see a male bear, punch or kick it in the dick. Listen, guys, if you take anything away from this show this evening, it's that if you're ever out in the wild and you see a male bear, kick it in the dick. That's just science.